Hello again. In the last video, we have seen how to install DWM. Now we will see how to patch it. There are three different ways we can patch it. I will show all three of them in this video. Right now, what you are seeing is heavily patched DWM. It is my custom build. So for example, you can see the transparency and the gaps, and I use Rofi, not DWM. Now we will have a look at virtual machine where we have our previous system. Here I have created three different directories, so DWM, DWM flexipatch and DWM git. So this one is the currently running system. Okay, now let's see how we can patch it. So here I have opened Suckless website. Let's move it to a different one. So under DWM we can see patches, and here we will see full gaps. So full gaps, so this is the one we are applying today. So to apply a patch, you just need to download this zip file. We will save it at repos. Here we can see the full gaps patch, and to install the patch, so the first method is, if we go to DWM folder, here we need to say patch minus p1 and then provide the patch file. And here we can see it is applied the patch to config.dev, but it is failed to apply the patch at dwm.c. And to correct that, we open the two files, dwm.c.rejected and dwm.c. And when we open, we see these are the three changes which are not applied. So here we copy these two lines and go to the DWM file. So first we need to check where it is. So it is in tile function. So here, go to this DWM file, search for tile. Here it is. No, not yet. Here. And we can check, it is at what line. So it says under for loop. So we need to paste at here. So we pasted this file, and we also need to remove these two lines. So remove these two, add these two lines. So the first one is done. Now we will check what are the difference between the config.dev file and our config file. Here we can see there are three lines which are added. So we just copy these three lines and come here and paste them. Now they are the same lines. Now write this changes and quit, and quit this file. And now we have patched the DWM. Now make. So here we can see there is one line, one error, which says the gaps variable missing. So it is because we haven't copied it from. So here we can see it is here and it is not available into our file. So we just copy it, paste it here and quit. Now when we make, we can see no error. So we restart DWM and now we have gaps. And to control the gaps, we can see with alt minus and alt plus, alt equal to, we can increase or decrease. So alt minus and alt plus. Now we will see how to do it with flexipatch. So go to DWM flexipatch. So flexipatch is a project, GitHub project, which is like github.com. So if you go to github.com and the user BeckKB, he has this DWM flexipatch. So here what it does is it has all the patches already applied, and there is one file called patches.def. In this one, you just need to say enable or disable that particular patch. For example, to include alpha patch, you just need to say zero or one. If it is one, then it is enabled. If it is zero, then it is not enabled. So if you go to here and say patches.def, okay, patches.def.h, and here we need to search for, so here we have vanity gaps. It is a different types of gaps. So if you go to patches, you can see vanity gaps at the very end. So here, so it is similar to full gaps, but it is a combination of both full gaps and gaps. So you will have utmost control of your gaps. So enable that patch. So here as well, and just quit it and make. That's it. And if you want to, and then you need to install it. And now if you want to do it with a git style, then go to DWM git. Here when you first clone from source, so when you first clone it from the git link from here, then it will be in a master branch. So git status, so here you can see you are on the master branch. So here we need to create a different branch, git checkout minus b, say full gaps. And now we have a different branch, git status, and it says we are on branch full gaps. Here we can say git apply, and then we need to provide the path to the patch. So here again it says patch does not apply. It might fail, it might work. It depends on how the file was formatted and everything else, but this is how you can do it. So let's try a different example. So let's try this one. So this one is applied since there were no errors. And then you make and install it by sudo make install. And if you want to apply a different patch, then you check out the master branch. And now we can create a different patch, say alpha. Now we have seen all three different methods of patching DWM. So the efficient one is DWM flexipatch. With that, you just need to enable or disable a particular patch, or you can combine different patches in one go. And the other way is to just use patch command. But if you want to do it via git, the last method git apply, then there will be issues because you need to have a same files, or the patch should be formatted according to this version of master. So here we can see it was 6.1 and we have a 6.2 version of DWM. So this should work. So it says 6.2, but there cannot be guarantee it will work or not work, because the full gaps patch we had, it was supposed to work on 6.2, but it did not apply. So it's either patch command, patch minus p1, then path to patch, or DWM flexipatch. I hope you have learned new things in this video. I will catch you in the next video. Bye bye.